The proposed merger of Land Bank and the Development Bank of the Philippines, opposed by another lawmaker. Senator Rizo Ontiveros says the Marcos administration should tread cautiously on this proposal. She warns merging the two to create the country's largest bank in terms of assets would make it an entity that's too big to fail. Ontiveros says she will file a resolution urging the Senate to exercise its oversight function on the proposed merger. The chairman of the Senate Ways and Means Committee, Sherwin Gatchalian, had earlier warned the proposal could create a super monopoly.
Dahil may monopoly siya ng LGU deposits. At dati nakakapili pa yung mga LGUs between Land Bank or DDP, ngayon isa na lang. At wala silang choice. So kung masama ang servisyo ng super monopoly, wala silang choice. Mataas ang interest rate sa kanilang loans, wala silang choice. So it's bad for our local government.
Philippine medical experts urge the public to prepare for tropical diseases brought by the El Nino phenomenon. Department of Health Officer in Charge Maria Rosario Vergere cited a variety of possible epidemics such as cholera, dengue, malaria, and typhoid fever. She cautioned that most of these illnesses arise from the water crisis brought by the hot weather.
Most important would be na lahat tayo dapat aware tayo, lahat tayo alam natin ang gagawin natin kapag ka nangyari yan para maiwasan ang sakit. Katulad ng dapat siguraduhin lagi na ligtas ang tubig na ating iniinom. So it all boils down to good hygiene, good food preparation, and of course this source of water ay kailangan po laging malinis para maiwasan ang sakit.
The Philippine Federation of Professional Associations has outlined some measures to avoid heat exhaustion. It noted the most important is to stay hydrated by drinking at least 2 liters of water a day.
Huwag masyadong iinom at kakain ng matatamis kasi yun eh nakakaano yung sugar yung tubig para ilabas. Oh. Kaya yung soft drinks din natin binibigay sa mga yung uhaw na uhaw kasi lalo kang uuhawin. Oh. Lalo yung alcohol, dapat bawasan ang alcohol during summer.
Ukraine is eyeing Filipino investments and workers that will help the war-torn nation in its massive rebuilding efforts. That's according to the Chargé d'Affaires of the Ukrainian Embassy in Malaysia. He recently met with officials from the Philippine Defense, ICT, and Foreign Affairs departments in Manila. The Ukrainian government estimates they will need a whopping $1 trillion budget for its restoration efforts.
We will begin talks about the Filipinos' labor to come because this reconstruction effort will need significant increase in labor. You know, Ukraine, as majority of European states, is an aging country. This is not the situation here, and hardworking Filipinos will be very welcomed there to benefit our growth, and Filipino investors will be very much welcomed.
North Korea unveils new nuclear warheads during leader Kim Jong-un's visit to the country's Nuclear Weapons Institute. The Hwasan-31 illustrates the progress made by Pyongyang in miniaturizing warheads that can be fitted to intercontinental ballistic missiles. Kim has ordered a scaling up of production of weapons-grade nuclear equipment to grow the country's arsenal. Pyongyang has carried out an unprecedented number of missile tests in the past weeks, blaming the joint military drills by the U.S. and South Korea for raising tensions in the region.